Dear students, in this class we will discuss about strip lines and the types of strip lines. Strip line is transverse electromagnetic transmission line medium. Strip line is earliest form of planar transmission line. Strip line circuit uses a flat strip of metal which is sandwiched between two parallel ground planes. The insulating material of the substrate forms a dielectric. A strip line consists of a central thin conducting strip of width W which is greater than its thickness T. It is placed inside the low loss dielectric substrate of thickness D by 2 between two wide ground plates. The width of the ground plates is 5 times greater than the spacing between the plates. The thickness of metallic central conductor and the thickness of metallic ground planes are the same. The width of the strip, the thickness of the substrate, and the relative permittivity of the substrate determine the characteristic impedance of the strip. A strip line consists of conductor of width W centered in a dielectric material of thickness B and permittivity. Two ground planes separated by a distance B are placed above and below the strip line. The dielectric material may be of different materials and thickness above and below the conductor, leading to inhomogeneous strip line. Because of the insulation provided by the dielectric casing, the strip line can be easily miniaturized and provides enhanced noise immunity in microwave circuits. The presence of the homogeneous dielectric between the conducting ground planes supports the TEM mode of propagation. Similar to coaxial lines, the strip line is also capable of supporting higher order modes of propagation, is non-dispersive and has no cutoff frequency. The impedance of a strip line is inversely proportional to the ratio of the width W of the inner conductor to the distance B between the ground planes. Strip lines are most easily constructed on the inner layers of multi-layer printed circuit boards. Microstrip line is a type of electrical transmission line which can be fabricated with any technology, where a conductor is separated from a ground plane by a dielectric layer known as a substrate. Microwave components such as antennas, couplers, filters, power dividers, etc. can be formed from microstrip, with the entire device existing as the pattern of metallization on the substrate. Microstrip is thus much less expensive than traditional waveguide technology, as well as being far lighter and more compact. The disadvantages of microstrip compared with waveguide are the generally lower power handling capacity and higher losses. Also, unlike waveguide, microstrip is typically not enclosed and is therefore susceptible to crosstalk and unintentional radiation. For lowest cost, microstrip devices may be built on an ordinary standard PCB substrate. Microstrip lines are also used in high-speed digital PCB designs where signals need to be routed from one part of the assembly to another with minimal distortion and avoiding high crosstalk and radiation. Microstrip is one of the many forms of planar transmission line. Others include strip line and coplanar waveguide, and it is possible to integrate all of these on the same substrate. A microstrip line consists of a conductor of width W, a dielectric substrate of thickness D, and permittivity. The presence of the dielectric concentrates the field lines in the region between the conductor and the ground plane, with some fraction being in the air region above the conductor, leading to quasi-TEM modes of propagation in which dispersion occurs as a function of wavelength. The characteristic impedance of a microstrip is a function of the strip line width, thickness t, and distance between the line and the ground plane h. The major advantage of microstrip over strip line is that all active components can be mounted on top of the board. The disadvantages are that when high isolation is required, such as in a filter or switch, some external shielding may have to be considered. Given the chance, microstrip circuits can radiate, causing unintended circuit response. A minor issue with microstrip is that it is dispersive. Microstrip supports a quasi-TEM mode because of its filling factor. One symptom of microstrip's non-TEM behavior is for coupled lines, the even and odd modes will not have the same phase velocity. This property is what causes the asymmetric frequency of microstrip bandpass filters. Variants of microstrip include embedded microstrip and coated microstrip, both of which add some dielectric above the microstrip conductor. Characteristic impedance of microstrip lines. Microstrip lines are used extensively to interconnect high-speed logic circuits in digital computers because they can be fabricated by automated techniques and they provide the required uniform signal paths. The characteristic impedance of a microstrip line is a function of the strip line width, thickness, and the distance between the line and the ground plane, and the dielectric constant of the board material. The well-known equation of the characteristic impedance of a wire over ground transmission line is given by 60 divided by root of dielectric constant of the medium ln of 4 into height from the center of the wire to the ground plane divided by diameter of the wire. If the effective or equivalent values of the relative dielectric constant of the ambient medium and the diameter d of the wire can be determined for the microstrip line, the characteristic impedance of the microstrip line can be calculated. This is for when h is greater than diameter of the wire. Effective dielectric constant. For a homogeneous dielectric medium, the propagation delay time per unit length is root of product of permeability and permittivity of the medium. In free space, the propagation delay time is root of mu naught epsilon naught, which is equal to 3.33 nanosecond per meters. Propagation delay time for a line in a non-magnetic medium is 1.106 root of relative dielectric constant of the board material. The effective relative dielectric constant of a microstrip line can be related to the relative dielectric constant of the board material. Therefore, the effective relative dielectric constant for a microstrip line is equal to 0.475 multiplied with the relative dielectric constant of the board material plus 0.67. The cross section of a microstrip line is rectangular, so the rectangular conductor must be transformed into an equivalent circular conductor. The empirical equation for the transformation is d equal to 0.67 D is the diameter of the wire over ground is equal to 0.67 width of the microstrip line into 0.8 plus 1 divided by width of the microstrip line. The limitation of the ratio of thickness to width is between 0.1 and 0.8. Therefore, characteristic impedance Z0 is equal to 87 divided by root of relative dielectric constant of the board material plus 1.41 ln of 0.98 into height from the microstrip line to the ground divided by 0.8 width of the microstrip line plus thickness of the microstrip line. The velocity of propagation is equal to C divided by effective dielectric constant of the microstrip line, which is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by effective dielectric constant of the microstrip line in meter per second. Therefore, characteristic impedance for a wide microstrip line is expressed by height from the microstrip line to the ground divided by width of the microstrip line into root of permeability divided by permittivity, which is equal to 377 into H divided by relative dielectric constant of the board material into width of the microstrip line when width is greater than H. Most microstrip lines are made from boards of copper with a thickness of 1.4 or 2.8. The narrowest width of lines in production are about 0.005 minus 0.010 inches. Line widths are usually less than 0.020. Since the dielectric constant of the materials used does not vary excessively with frequency, the dielectric constant of a microstrip line can be considered independent of frequency. Microstrip transmission lines consisting of a conductive ribbon attached to a dielectric sheet with conductive backing are widely used in both microwave and computer technology because such lines are easily fabricated by printed circuit manufacturing techniques. They have economic and technical merit. The attenuation constant of the dominant microstrip made depends on geometric factors, electrical properties of the substrate and conductors, and on the frequency. For magnetic dielectric substrate, two types of losses occur in the dominant microstrip mode: dielectric loss in the substrate and ohmic skin loss in the strip, conductor and the ground plane. The sum of these two losses may be expressed as losses per unit length in terms of an attenuation factor alpha. From ordinary transmission line theory, the power carried by a wave traveling in positive z direction is equal to half into VI, which is equal to half V plus e to the power minus alpha Z I plus e to the power minus alpha Z. So half into magnitude of voltage divided by Z naught e to power minus 2 alpha Z. Therefore, P is equal to P naught e to the power minus 2 alpha z, where p naught is equal to square of v divided by 2 z naught is the power at z equal to 0. The attenuation constant alpha is equal to power dp divided by dz divided by 2 into power in z direction, which is equal to dielectric attenuation constant plus ohmic attenuation constant. The gradient of power in a z direction can be further expressed in terms of the power loss per unit length dissipated by the resistance and the power loss per unit length in the dielectric. That is equal to d by dz of half vi. Which is equal to half into minus dv by dz plus half into minus di by dz v, which is equal to half into r into I to I plus half into sigma into v. It is equal to half into I square into r plus half into v square into sigma, which is equal to power AC plus PD, where sigma is the conductivity of the dielectric substrate board. We have equation 2, that is alpha attenuation constant . We have equation 3, substitute equation 3 in equation 2 results in dielectric attenuation is equal to PD divided by 2 P of Z Napier's per meter. Ohmic attenuation is PC divided by 2 P of Z Napier's per meter. Dielectric losses. When the conductivity of a dielectric cannot be neglected, the electric and magnetic fields in the dielectric are no longer in time phase. The dielectric attenuation constant is given by alpha d is equal to conductivity of the dielectric substrate board in mole per centimeter divided by 2 into root of permeability divided by permittivity. this dielectric constant can be expressed in terms of dielectric loss tangent its tan theta is equal to equation 2 and equation 1. Then the dielectric attenuation constant is equal to, when substituting the equation 2 in equation 1, we will get dielectric attenuation constant root of permeability into permittivity into tan theta. Since the microstrip line is a non-magnetic mixed dielectric system, the upper dielectric above the dielectric ribbon is air, in which no loss occurs. An expression for the dielectric attenuation constant alpha d is equal to 4.34 root of mu naught divided epsilon naught when the medium is air. Therefore, alpha d is equal to 1.634 into 10 to the power 3 cube sigma root of epsilon r e, effective dielectric constant of the substrate, where q denotes dielectric filling factor. Q is equal to effective dielectric constant of the substrate minus 1 divided by dielectric constant of the board. We usually express the attenuation constant dielectric per wavelength is alpha d is equal to 27.3 Q relative permittivity of the material divided by relative effective dielectric constant of the substrate tan theta divided by wavelength. Where lambda g is equal to lambda naught wavelength in free space, effective dielectric divided by root of effective dielectric constant of the substrate, which is equal to C divided by F into root of relative effective dielectric constant of the substrate. C is the velocity of light in vacuum. If the loss tangent tan theta is independent of frequency, the dielectric attenuation per wavelength is also independent of frequency. If the substrate conductivity is independent of frequency, as for a semiconductor, the dielectric attenuation per unit is also independent of frequency. Ohmic losses. In a microstrip line over a low-loss dielectric substrate, the predominant sources of losses at microwave frequencies are the non-perfect conductors. The current density in the conductors of a microstrip line is concentrated in a sheet that is approximately infinite skin depth thick inside the conductor surface and exposed to the electric field. Both the strip conductor thickness and the ground plane thickness are assumed to be at least 3 or 4 skin depths thick. The microstrip conductor contributes the major part of the ohmic loss. The conducting attenuation constant of a wide microstrip line is given by alpha c is equal to 8.686 rs divided by z naught decibel per centimeter for width divided by height greater than 1, where rs is equal to root of 1/√surface skin resistance ohm per square. It can be 1 by delta into sigma. Again, it's in ohm per square. Delta is equal to root of 1 divided by pi f mu sigma is the skin depth. In centimeter. In addition to the conductor and electric losses, microstrip line also has radiation losses. The radiation loss depends on the substrate's thickness and dielectric constant. The radiation loss for several discontinuities using the sum of the approximations. One is transverse electric and magnetic field transmission, uniform dielectric, in the neighborhood of the strip equal in magnitude to an effective value, neglect of radiation from the transverse electric field component parallel to the strip, substrate thickness, much less than the free space wavelength. The ratio of radiated power to total dissipated power for an open circuited microstrip line is where F of epsilon Re is a radiation factor and is given by in which epsilon Re is the effective dielectric constant and lambda naught is equal to by f is the free space wavelength. The radiation factor decreases with increasing substrate dielectric constant. So, radiation, P radiation divided by Pt, which is equal to Rrn divided by Z0, where R is radiation resistance. Of an open circuited microstrip and is given by 240 pi square s divided by lambda naught square f into f of epsilon re. The ratio of the radiation resistance to the real part of the characteristic impedance of the microstrip line is equal to a small fraction of the power radiated from a single open circuit discontinuity. The radiation loss decreases. Radiation loss decreases when the characteristic impedance increases. For lower dielectric constant substrates, radiation is significant at higher impedance levels. For higher dielectric constant substrates, radiation becomes significant until very low impedance levels are reached. Many microwave integrated circuits require very high quality resonant circuits. The quality factor of a microstrip line is very high, but it is limited by the radiation losses of the substrates and with low dielectric constant. For uniform current distribution in the microstrip line, the ohmic attenuation constant of a wide microstrip line is given by (8.686 Rs) divided by Z0 and width, and that the characteristic impedance of a wide microstrip line is 1.2. The wavelength in the microstrip line since QC is related to the conductor attenuation constant, QC is equal to 27.3 divided by alpha C. Quality factor is related to the conductor attenuation constant, that is 27.3 divided by alpha C. Quality factor for wide microstrip line is expressed as 39.5 H divided by Rs into frequency in gigahertz, where Rs is equal to root of pi f permeability divided by sigma, which is equal to 2 pi root of frequency in gigahertz divided by sigma in ohm per square. Therefore, quality factor for wide microstrip line is 0.63 H root of sigma frequency in gigahertz. For a copper strip, alpha equal to 5.8 into 10^7 mho per meter. Then quality factor for copper strip is equal to 4780 into h root of frequency in gigahertz. A quality factor is related to dielectric attenuation constant is given by 27.3 divided by alpha d. Therefore, quality factor related to dielectric attenuation constant is lambda naught root of effective dielectric constant into tan theta, which is nothing but 1 divided by tan theta. So lambda naught is the free space wavelength in centimeter.